Hello everyone, welcome to the daily reading. This is your daily message for tomorrow, Saturday, September 25th, 2021, for all signs. All signs that may be watching. Sorry to sit outside today, get some sun. I'm sitting on my porch. I just feel like doing a reading outside today. So hope you guys can enjoy your weekends, relax, get some fresh air, walk around the neighborhood, see your friends. Get out, get some sun on your face, wherever you are. If there's not sun, well, walk in the rain. We're using the Tarot Familiars deck today for your reading by Lisa Parker. I was thinking about, my dog is, the dog that I had for the last 14 years. She passed away October 2 or 3 years ago, I forget. Her anniversary is coming up October 3rd, but I do get signs that she has been around. You know what I mean? Like, I find stuff from her. Like, the other day I found, this is kind of gross, but I don't know why I feel the need to mention this. It's why I'm using this deck. Anyway, so maybe she's a familiar spirit around here. But yeah, I did find, like, an old tooth or something laying around, so... She definitely has a way of letting me know that she's still around. It's a little bit windy out here. Let's see. Making sure all the cards are here. All right, so let's see what's going on for the collective for tomorrow. Saturday, September 25th, 2021, for all signs. All signs that may be watching. What do they need to know? What are the most important messages and energies you have for my viewers? Let's do three good shuffles here. It's gonna be, I don't know how difficult this is gonna be. No oracle cards today, guys. Just what's going on for the collective tomorrow? Messages and energies for my viewers. Let's do one more. Very windy. I mean, it's kind of breezy. I would say windy. Chicago, we have winds are no joke here. I was going to say there ain't no joke. The winds are no joke here, but it's just a little breezy today, so you have to bear with me. We have the Two of Wands reversed, Aries. I'm going to put this under my coffee cup here, okay, so it doesn't fly away. We have the King of Wands, fire sign, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. We'll be dealing with fire signs tomorrow. We have the Death card, Scorpio. Scorpio. It's not quite Scorpio season. I'm going into Libra season, but you know, I know Venus is in Scorpio, and probably a whole bunch of planets will move into Scorpio before we even get there, because that's how it's been going. The bottom of the deck, we have the Knave of Wands. Fire sign energy again. Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. So, the underlying theme or challenge of a reading is adventure. Okay. Knave of Wands, adventurous energy, travel, exploration. This is about... you got to get the experience under your belt before you can become a king. But we also have a king of wands here. All right. We've got the Two of Wands reversed. We don't know where to begin. We're maybe not looking in the right direction. Maybe we feel like we don't have options. There could also be a feeling here of feeling directionless, or that we don't know what direction to look in. King of Wands says, take action, make a plan. If it's about starting a business, starting a company, or travel, pick some place that you're passionate about. What would the King of Wands do in any situation? It's all about the mindset, really. Passionate, fearless leader. You got to put yourself out there. that's what it's about. And then we have the death card here, Scorpio. And that's all about transformation, change. So this reading could also resonate with someone that doesn't know where to start in terms of their own life, how they want to transform, they want to change, they don't know where to begin. And the Knave of Wands says, tomorrow is all about exploring your options. It's all about putting yourself out there. Most people out there that have led Fortune 500 companies, and not even that, just some of the best people out there, business or otherwise, are ones that have been unafraid to fail and done so publicly. And me and my own family, I've witnessed the whole life cycle of a business from beginning to end. And the thing is that a fearless leader isn't afraid to start again, even if that means you have to end something. That just means that there's room for new beginnings. So I see potential, I see options, even if it doesn't seem like there are many. So that's what I have for you guys tomorrow. I hope you enjoy your weekends. I hope you enjoy your Saturday. And I'll see you guys back tomorrow for another daily message. Take care.